colleagues and opera lovers, I am Maria Zoe from Atelier d'Excellence. Welcome to PRELUDE, a mini interview series about opera. Our interview today is dedicated to young artist programs as a jumping point for a young singer's career. Young artist programs are institutions that are in place for developing young singers into professionals until they are ready to start a major operatic career. We will discuss the transition from young artist to young professional with our guest, American soprano Miss Leah Hawkins. Leah is an alumna of the Caffrey's Young Artist Program of the Washington National Opera. She also recently completed the Lindemann Young Artist Development Program of the Metropolitan Opera of New York. Leah, welcome to PRELUDE.
Thank you. Thank you for having me.
It is an honor and joy to have you with us today. How are you?
I'm doing well. I am adjusting to this new way of existing, and it's tough at times, but I'm learning so much.
Great to hear that. I will start with my first question for you. You received your master's in music from Yale University. How did you subsequently find yourself at the Young Artist Program of Washington National Opera?
So in my second season or second year of graduate school at Yale, I started to apply to young artist programs. And at the time, I was actually discouraged by some people that I'd worked with from applying to certain programs. So I only applied to two because I said, well, I'll try two. And if I don't get one of those, then I'll stay at Yale for an artist diploma. So I applied to two. I applied to Washington National Opera, their Young Artist Program, and I also applied to Minnesota Opera's Young Artist Program. And I sang for Minnesota, I think it was first, and I didn't get a call back for Minnesota. They give same-day callbacks, and I didn't get a call back. So all I had was Washington, and I said, uh-oh, okay. So I sang for Washington, and it was a really great audition. And I got the sense that they wanted me even in that audition. And so I got a call back that day. And then I was invited to finals a few weeks later. And then at finals, I pretty much knew that I was in. I think the person who hired me, Michael Houston, he saw something in me. So he wanted to invest in me. So I think I got really, really lucky in that way.
It was your destiny somehow.
I think so. I think I was supposed to be there. It's clear to me.
I would like to ask you, what are the benefits of a top-rated young artist program for a young artist in terms of artistic growth, stage experience, and visibility?
So there are quite a few. You know, we get a lot of time on stage, a lot of time in front of important people in the business. We get access to those people and those connections, and often those people that, you know, the coaches and conductors and people you get to sing with will recommend you for other things and hire you for other things. But aside from that, the financial help that you get from these programs is essential, especially in these beginning stages. So to have someone pay for your voice lessons and your coachings and your travel to auditions and to performances, it's really helpful in that way. You know, clothing stipends, so all of your needs to develop as a singer are taken care of through these programs, and that's certainly been a huge benefit for me to get to travel. You know, they paid for me to go to Italy and Germany and to get to do language study, like just, you know, really, really beneficial things for a young developing singer.
You can develop, I guess, in a very protected space. This is very important.
Yes.
The world is wild when you're a freelancer without the studios behind you as a young
Absolutely. Person. You are on your own. And so to know that you have the support of a whole company is like, it's very comforting, very comforting.
Lee, despite the common perception that artists select agents, We in AdE believe that agents select artists. According to your experience, is it more likely for a young singer to be discovered during a young artist program or afterwards?
In my experience and in the experience of some of my colleagues, you're likely to be discovered by an agent when in a program, but you're not likely to be signed until your second season or your third season when you're about to finish the program. Because while you're in the program, agents can't negotiate the contracts that come from the company that you're employed by. So whatever contracts you get for main stage, you have to accept them as they are. Agents cannot negotiate that. And then also your time belongs to that company while you're a young artist. So it's a bit, sometimes it can be a bit hard for an agent to really do good work for you while you're still in a program. But often I've seen a lot of people, like I signed with my agent at the end of my first year at the MET program, but I met him and he started watching me when I was in my second season in Washington. And so once he knew that I was going to the MET program, he then kept following me and then waited to sign me a little bit, you know, a little later. And then you also have to have things to manage. There's no sense in having a manager if you don't have enough offers coming in. And I think that was the deciding factor for my manager, was it was getting to a point where I was writing him and asking him for help on gigs. What do you think about these offers? Or what do you think about this? It's like, oh, okay. Now she has things that she needs help with. And that, I think that's what made him go, finally, okay, let's sign a contract and start.
Are you allowed to sing in other gigs except from the house that you are working for as a young artist?
Absolutely, yes. As long as it doesn't conflict with anything major, at least, in the program, absolutely. Sometimes, I mean, I once, when I was in Washington, I'll never forget, we had this concert we had to do, and it was largely for our patrons of the program. And I got offered a symphony gig with the Indianapolis Symphony. And so I was like, I really want to do this. He said, okay, you can do it. But I had to fly to rehearsal in Indianapolis on Friday, fly back to DC on Saturday, and then fly back to Indianapolis Saturday night, just to be able to do both the concert in DC and the concert in Indianapolis. So that's an example of how, like, your time doesn't exactly belong to you in programs.
These things actually prepare you to be a professional, and they, mm-hmm. they know that you have these qualities if you're able to work under this pressure.
Yes.
So some things.
Yes. Absolutely.
Leah, I wanted to ask, what are your most cherished one or two memories as a young artist in those programs?
Oh, I have so many. But I guess the first one would be in Washington again. So Washington was doing a production of AIDA, and they had double cast it with two different AIDAs. And one of the AIDAs decided to back out of the production. And so at the last moment, I got a call that said, hey, would you like to cover AIDA? And I was like, what? Me? Because I had learned the role previously, but I had never, you know, done anything, you know, with it outside of a coaching room. And I was actually headed out of the country. I was headed to another performance. And they said, well, we need a cover. Can you come back early from your performance and start? And I said, yes, absolutely. So I got to cover the cover AIDA. And they said initially that they wanted me to cover only for the beginning of the run until they got another lady in place. And then they ended up letting me cover the whole run. And then I got to sing Act Two with orchestra for this performance for school children. And so I got to do it in front of 2,000 school children. and it was just the most magical thing, because it was my first time in this role on stage, first time singing part of the role with orchestra. I will never forget that memory. I will never forget hearing those children cheer for me. So next time I sing AIDA, it's gonna have to live up to that.
Yeah, you have a memory, wonderful memory to follow you with AIDA. Yeah. And yeah. What a role, right?
Yeah. And my other memory is actually recently, I was asked to do the memorial service for Jesse Norman at the Met. And being asked was a complete honor because she's one of my heroes. And she's one of the women who inspired me to pursue a career. So to get to honor her life in that way was just so incredibly special. I'm really grateful for that experience too.
Lee, after a recent event, there has been a global outpouring of solidarity for people of color. How did you overcome racial challenges in your career up to this point?
Well, I feel like I fight challenges by being my most authentic self and by walking into spaces proud of myself as a Black woman and as a Black singer, because everyone won't like me. Everyone won't, that I walk into a space to share with, won't appreciate my talents. And some people will judge me based on how I look. And I can't control that. But what I can control is being prepared and singing with love. And that's what I try to do. And that's my protest, is me showing up as myself and being proud of that. Wearing my natural hair and wearing my African attire and being sure of who I am. That's my protest. And some people will get it. Some people will get my talents and they will be on board with it, and others won't. And that's okay. That's also okay too. I don't have the time to spend the energy to spend worrying about people who don't like people like me. It's okay.
I think we artists have a unique power to change things with our work. Mm-hmm. And we have a responsibility to talk, like of course every other member of this society, but especially artists, we have a power. We have to take advantage of this and change the world.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
Let's go to something more pleasant now. you had a brilliant start in your career, really. Mm. Would you like to share with us any future plans?
Well, I was just going to say, you know, aside from singing, I've become very passionate about working with children and doing my part to give back in that way, because it's really important to me. There's nothing quite like seeing a child's eyes light up when they hear live music, maybe for the first time, and then to hear their questions. Children are just so brilliant in the way that they hear and see the world. And often I find now I'm trying to see the world in the way that I did when I was a child, you know? I miss that innocence and that I miss things being new in the way that it was when I was a child. So aside from that, I am on the advisory board for an arts organization for children. It brings art and opera to children. So I'm really looking forward to being more involved in that. We've been trying to plan a virtual gala of some sort. And we've also been doing like lullabies for children, because some children are struggling through, you know, this really strange time. So that's one of my biggest, that's one of my next steps at the moment. And aside from that, all of my gigs in the United States have been canceled until 2021. And I am still waiting to hear if I will get back to Europe for the Seven Deaths of Maria Callas, the opera project that I was supposed to do this summer. So they were hoping to actually open the season at the Bayerische Staatsoper in September with our piece, but we don't know yet. We just have to wait and see what happens in the next few months. Otherwise, if that doesn't happen, you know, if that's not rescheduled for right now, I am looking at my next gig being February, and I will be doing some concerts in Italy in February.
But this gives you the time to prepare, and we must turn it into something positive. We have more time to prepare. We have more time to develop other things that we are. We are not only singers. We are human beings with many different sides. And I think you have many sides in your personality that you can take advantage of and do nice different things. So let's release our creativity and think positive.
We have to stay positive, you know, and we have to be flexible. None of us could have predicted this. None of us want this. But it is a time to reflect on who we are outside of just being singers and givers in that way. Like, who am I? You know, I'm trying to, I know who I am, I think I do. But a lot of that has been, you know, a lot of my identity is centered around me being a singer. And so I can't sing in the same way. So I have to focus on other aspects of myself.
So, very right. Getting to the end of our conversation, I would like to ask you, what advice would you give to young singers starting now their career?
Yeah, starting now, I would say, you know, focus on being the best version of you and not of anyone else. Be your most individual self, because that's the beauty of us, is that we're so individual and that we have all have different things to say, and we interpret things in different ways. So when you enter, you know, the world or enter a program or whatever, don't forget to be you. And we all know to work hard and to do our best. That's what we plan to do anyway. But don't forget, we need you. And also, don't forget why you decided to sing in the first place. It wasn't about being perfect, I'm sure. It wasn't about, you know, the prestige. It was about the love of singing and the love of making people feel good. So don't forget those things. Don't ever forget.
That is a great advice. It's actually a very good bridge for our next webinar, because it's going to be visiting exactly this objective, that doing it right doesn't guarantee anything, doesn't guarantee success. You have to do it right and uniquely. You have to do it on your own way.
Yes.
Lee, thank you so much for sharing your journey with us. As another acclaimed young artist, Operalia First Prize winner, Levi Strauss-Agapan, a tenor, said, "The transition from young artist to young professional starts with a hunger for the art form." Mm-hmm. I think that you're a bright example of this advice. And we wish you continued success in your singing path.
Thank you so much. It was such a joy talking to you. I always love talking to you, really. Thank you so much.
It was great having you with us. And I think people took very valuable advice for the Young Artist Programs and for the singing path in general. And let's extend a warm thanks to our audience for your attendance. Stay well, stay creative. Until we meet again at Prelude.